Hello and welcome to this tutorial focused on updated subsidence information as part of DWR's Sustainable Groundwater Management Act technical assistance. DWR has two primary roles in implementation of SGMA. The first is an assistance role and is the topic of today's discussion. The purpose of this assistance is to provide funding, planning, and technical assistance to local water managers and related entities to use in developing and implementing their groundwater sustainability plans with the goal of achieving statewide sustainable groundwater management. One form of technical assistance is the SGMA data viewer, as you can see on the screen. The purpose of the SGMA data viewer is to compile and display regional and statewide groundwater information so groundwater sustainability agencies and related stakeholders can efficiently access this information during groundwater sustainability plan development and implementation. Objective data access is and will continue to be an important component of successful GSP development and SGMA implementation. Currently, SGMA-related data are managed and stored in a variety of local, state, and federal agencies, making it difficult to find. The SGMA data viewer integrates data from various sources to provide GSAs and the public with access to query, visualize, and download SGMA relevant data. The data viewer provides data mapped to SGMA sustainability indicators shown on the left side of the screen. DWR has recently updated the SGMA data viewer to include updated subsidence information to help groundwater sustainability agencies, water managers, and others implement the act. DWR is providing these standardized statewide data sets to assist GSAs in their planning efforts, and the new information is available on this application and includes an existing historical subsidence information and updated satellite-based remote sensing INSAR data from June 2015 to June 2018. INSAR is a technique of mapping ground deformation using radar images of the Earth's surface and is collected from orbiting satellites. So now we'll go and demo the new subsidence related information. As mentioned, on the left side of the SGMA data viewer, there are categories of information related to the sustainability indicators. The subject of today is the land subsidence information. DWR has provided existing subsidence information, including DWR extensometers, USGS extensometers, and other sites. The new updated information includes an estimated vertical displacement of the land surface from the 1949 to 2005 timeframe. This information is provided for reference material. Can zoom in and look at the information, as well as transparency functions to change those features. In addition to this new historical information, there is updated INSAR imagery, the TRE Altamira INSAR dataset, which includes rasters or spatial coverages of vertical displacement shown on the screen here for a variety of basins in the state. When zooming in to a particular area of interest, you can click on the rasters. It brings up a field of the interpolated displacement value for the time period of June 13th, 2015 to June 1st, 2018. When clicking on the displacement value in the table, it brings up another dialog box that shows the location of where it was you were clicked and a time series of vertical displacement from June 15 to June 2018. You can also download this information in a tabular format in a CSV or Excel file, and you click on this and it brings up a downloaded file. Another feature related to this raster NSAR dataset is the grid that was used to generate the rasters, the vertical displacement point data. This layer requires you to be zoomed in fairly close to, in order for the layer to turn on. When you turn on the layer, you can click on one of these grid cells, which brings up another tab in the table of results. You click on the vertical displacement point data, and it gives you the point code. When clicking on the link to the point code, it brings up the same dialog box with where the grid that is selected is located on a map and the time series information. An added benefit of this grid is that each of these grid points have additional time history that goes back to January 1st, 2015 through June 1st, 2018. You can also download these grid or point data sets in a tabular format in CSV or Excel. The location of or additional information related to these rasters and the point data related to the TRE Altamira NSAR dataset. When hovering over the layer name, there's an info icon that pops up. You click on that info icon, and it brings up metadata related to the layer, the description, a description of the service and host location, and other guidance and other related information, as well as contact information. This information is stored on the California Natural Resources Agency Open Data Platform under the TRE Altamira NSAR Subsidence Dataset. There is a technical report that explains how the NSAR data was collected and reported. There is a link to this tutorial, as well as a link to the SGMA Data Viewer, and a link to the GIS image services of vertical displacement rasters, where you can directly link to your own data system using an API. There's additional information on these layers on this open data page, including contact information for additional questions or additional information if needed. The next steps on where we plan to go on subsidence monitoring in California related to SGMA technical assistance, there are two components. The first component is ground-based data. We plan to continue to improve upon the existing statewide subsidence monitoring network, which means installing continuous GPS stations in the Central Valley that will be coming over the next year or two. We plan to continue a partnership with the U.S. Geological Survey to fund the collection and reporting of subsidence data from extensometers, primarily in the San Joaquin Valley. The other path of future data collection and reporting related to subsidence is remote sensing data. We plan to continue to provide statewide NSAR datasets like shown in this tutorial and other subsidence information related to SGMA implementation. Our current plan is to procure future NSAR datasets, so pick up on where this TRE Altamira NSAR dataset left off on June 1st, 2018, and carry that through October 2019. We plan to have that amount of information available in the spring of 2020. We plan to then do another year of NSAR data collection, extending this time series that starts all the way back in January 2015 to go through October 2020. That information will be available targeting spring 2021. We do plan to continue pursuing NSAR imagery as we understand that this is an important piece of information for SGMA moving forward, and we plan to procure future years moving forward. For additional information on SGMA-related data or tools, there is a DWR Groundwater Data and Tools webpage shown at the link there on the slide. And for any future questions or more general questions on DWR's technical assistance, please visit the sgmps@water.ca.gov email or send an email to that address. Thank you for listening to today's tutorial, and we look forward to any questions on this subsidence information. Thank you.